हेलो, लेट्स डिस्कस अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम थर्मोडायनामिक्स। हियर बेसिकली अ कार इंजन बर्न्स 5 kg ऑफ फ्यूल एट 1500 केल्विन एंड रिलीज़ एनर्जी टू द रेडिएटर एंड एग्जॉस्ट एट एन एवरेज टेम्परेचर ऑफ 750। सो यू हैव एट 1500 केल्विन 5 kg ऑफ फ्यूल विच इज़ बर्न। सो एट 1500 केल्विन यू हैव सम एनर्जी दैट इज़ कमिंग फ्रॉम 5 kg of fuel, and it is rejected by means rejected to the radiator as well as to the exhaust, as well as some amount is converted into the work. So I am just considering a very simple case. Okay, so some amount is given to the produced as water, and some is rejected to the exhaust and plus radiator and whatever other means you have for rejecting. So if I build a cycle, I mean assume any cycle, it can be any cycle. I mean you can fit a auto cycle or a diesel cycle or whatever cycle. Typically a car engine has a auto cycle if it is a petrol, and diesel if it is a diesel cycle. So this is how it is analyzed in a, I mean in a 1D, I mean in a very lumped case it is analyzed in this way. What is asked is, if the fuel provides 40,000 kilojoules per kg, okay, so that is 1 kg of fuel you want, you get 40,000 kilojoules per kg. So how much is the amount of heat that we get, QH is, now we know the mass of the burnt fuel into the calorific value. The calorific value is what is we get at per kg of fuel. So we want at 5 kg and we get 40,000 kg. So this means 20, so it's like 2 into 10 power 5, 2 into we get 22 into 10 power 5, kilojoules. Yeah, or the other way what you can write it, because 10 power 3 again, so 200 megajoules of energy we get from by burning the fuel. Now what is asked is, what is the maximum amount of work that can be done? Now maximum amount of work is possible when you have the best possible cycle between the 1500 Kelvin and the exhaust, which is assumed to be 750 Kelvin. If you assume the maximum possible, so if you assume the best cycle, theoretically it's possible only when you have a Carnot cycle. This has been proved in the by different ways from the second law. So when you have a second Carnot cycle, so let's see the efficiency of the Carnot cycle. The efficiency of the Carnot cycle, like for any other engine, the efficiency, we'll first write down the normal formula. The normal formula is work done by heat added. Work done again is difference from the heat added to the heat rejected. Now for Carnot only we have a special relation which relates the heat addition by heat rejected to the temperature. It varies in the ratio of the temperature of the source and the temperature of the sink. Okay, so that is nothing but so based on this, so this is the relation existing only for the Carnot cycle. Now based on this, this will be modified as TH minus TL or TR if you want to write. So let's write TR, TR by TH. Now we know these temperatures, so 1500 minus 750 by 1500, this comes out to be, the efficiency comes out to be 750 by 2, 1 by 2. So the best possible cycle will give you 50% of the efficiency. I mean any other real cycles, like your auto cycle, diesel cycle, will give you less than this. So what is asked is the maximum work. So maximum work will be, obviously the work from this equation, the maximum work will be, the work is efficiency of Carnot, because the Carnot is the best engine, into QH. So efficiency of Carnot we got half, into QH we already got to be 200. So 200 megajoules, so this comes out to be 100 megajoules. So 100 megajoules is the answer, the maximum work that can be produced. Thank you.